Good evening, Andreas. Nice to see you here, says Veronica. Grandpa, look who it is.
Eh?
Oh, the artist. You're still around?
Well, he told me to find you at the bonfire.
Did I? Guess I did.
Seems like you... this is such a weird... What the hell?
Seems like you've got some sense, then. So, do you have your mask?
No, I'm sorry.
Put your life in danger for all I care. The masks are to protect us as we banish the witches and spirits into Perkta's path.
And I think the masks are these, then.
Just a bucket. You're literally just wearing a bucket. That's not a mask. I have a mask, then. I'll put my shoe on my head. Or something to that extent.
That's... Okay, whatever. I mean, I'm just saying. If a bucket stands for a mask, I can say yes. Even though I didn't see it coming.
She punishes all humans she finds in the woods on St. John's Eve, since only witches are out in the wilderness.
Oh, no. Oh, no, Perkta. He's going to murder my apprentice because he doesn't have a mask.
Anyone caught will be turned into animals. No one but a priest can turn you back.
Oh, no. Oh, that's mocking him. Well, I guess I can imagine a worse punishment.
You joke, artist, but you won't be laughing when Perkta finds you. Stay indoors tonight. If you want to come outside, stay within the light of St. John's fire. At least St. Satya blesses the herbs in the forest this night. And the women will gather the herbs, regardless of that bastard abbot.
It's certainly important to stockpile some for the winter.
Thank you for teaching me more about the local traditions. Hey, Big York!
Oh?
You grab some of those ashes with you after the bonfire has died down.
Fine.
Clever. The ashes will be good for the soil in your garden. You're a smart ass for a city boy, eh? Best we drive the cattle across the ashes, too. Keeps them from disease.
Now that story time is over, says Veronica. How are you enjoying the evening so far, Andreas?
Oh, I've spoken to, a few other people here. Very enlightening. It's the best time to spend time with your friends. Have you heard anything interesting? Heh, gossip. You two are like that burner in the forest. Smokey, that's the one.
Yeah, we remember Smokey.
Always nosy about other people.
Why is it ignored him? Because this one is ignoring him as well. That's kind of weird, isn't it? I've also been invited to have dinner with the abbot. I guess the talking never stops. Can't say I'm exceedingly sure about it, given the animosity between us.
The abbot. The bastard can rot for all I care. A thief in a monk's robe, full of hollow words.
Maybe you can talk some sense into Father Journeau. He's not making it easy for us, any of us. It's not like we're asking for much. I'll do what I can. All we can ask. I guess I shouldn't keep you then. You have an important meeting to attend. You're right, I can't keep the abbot waiting too long. Until later. Oh, we've taken a lot of your time, haven't we? Don't forget to enjoy the night celebrations. Oh, could I have talked to them before, I wonder? Maybe. But either way, I think that conversation was meant to be had before dinner. Perhaps. Hello, Master Mallor. Evening, Teal. Enjoying the festival?
Very much so. I perhaps feel a tad old for the more active side of the celebrations, but I enjoy the sights and sounds. Did you know the word for the summer solstice leads back to the Romans?
Oh, I thought you didn't read Latin.
I've picked up a few words over the years, and I still have the mind to put two and two together.
Admirable, I must admit.
It's nothing, Master Mallor. Mainly proverbs and the occasional word, hence solstitium. Such as it looks at this time of year, the sun rises higher for a long time, and then it stays there before falling again. A fitting allegory for the great cosmic arc of mankind. Rise and fall. But to make up for that, dancing, leaping, songs, joy and mirth. people do seem elated, although I don't think the same applies to Abbot Journeau. Otto's courting danger, I agree. Going against the decrees of the Abbey like so. The festival has always had a rebellious streak of jest and mockery. I don't see it as sacred as some. It has to be sacred enough for the church not to condemn it as heretical. True enough, Master Mallor. I wish I could read more about all this. Well, with the Abbey selling books from their library. I hoped I could get some for myself, but it proved to be far too expensive. Klaus and his printings have proven to be of more use, and a fair bit cheaper. Does this mean you've read the 12 articles? I have. But that is not a talk to be had on this eve of celebration, Master Mallor. I see your point. Well, have you maybe come across any interesting tales? I have indeed, Master Mallor. Or, I didn't quite understand everything. The text was in Latin. It was by a Roman named Strabo, and it was about geography. That's why I noticed it. Oh, I don't believe I've had the chance to read anything by him. It was a fairly complicated read, I must admit. The book was about many kinds of barbarians, which also included the Raeti tribe I read about years ago. The people who used to live in this very land before the Romans arrived. He called this place Ratium and described it as a cluster of daub huts. Daub. Ah, I thought it was adobe. No, adobe must be the bricks. Daub is earth. Like, it's a type of construction. It's difficult. I don't actually know exactly what it is, so I don't know how to describe it very well. And its people, hostile and warlike, only interested in hunting and fishing. Oh, sorry, fighting. There was something about Manus and his sons, but I couldn't understand a lot of it. In any case, when the Romans came, most of these locals were driven out, but some were captured to work in the fields and the mines. What happened to the locals who were forced out? No idea. I would imagine that after the Romans were driven off, when their empire started falling apart, maybe the barbarians came back. But were they really the same people or nomads from elsewhere? I guess we may never know. Thank you for the quick history. I'll let you get back to the festivities. Enjoy yourself tonight, Master Mallor. Until later. Indeed. That sort of explains... I sort of forgot that he said that he can't read Latin. He had a comment about one of the books. The book that Martin stole, basically. That it was in German. And that's why I mean, that makes sense considering he probably reads German, but not Latin. Brigitta. Why, Martin, look how it is. Good evening, Andreas. Andreas, you're staying for the festival, I hope. Of course he's staying. Who would miss this, especially after you burly boys built such a beautiful bonfire? A burly boy like me could do anything for you, Dove. Couldn't help myself. Brigitta, Martin, you're both feeling very festive, I see. The food, the fires, the dancing, it really is a night to enjoy. It's to honor the anniversary of the birth of Blessed John, a vigil for he who prepared the way. Yes, yes, and he'd have liked everyone to have a good mood in their hearts and good food in their bellies. As a hermit who wandered in the desert, living off locusts and wild honey, he probably wouldn't agree. I'd like to live off some wild honey myself, if you catch my meaning. Should I snort? Let's see where that goes. Martin, please behave. She is smirking, though. Yes, dear, I'll pray to God to relieve me of my unclean thoughts. Tut, you'll get no dances tonight if you continue this impishness. See, Andreas, this is the kind of difficult married life I have to deal with. Quite. So what's next for the evening? Will you heed Odo's call and go into the forest? No, I'm not really looking for trouble. There's enough of that going around. Even though you supported him earlier during his speech. Yeah, he speaks his mind on what's important, but like I've said, I've no personal interest to provoke the abbot. We are Gort-fearing people, Andreas. And also, I think he might be going into the forest to show them St. John's head. Is that what's going to happen?
What did you argue about with Odo anyway when I first saw you in the meadow? Oh, nothing of note. Andreas, please, enough of this talk. We're here to celebrate. And Martin and I will dance until our legs begin to waver, isn't that right? Would not miss it for the world. That's delightful. I hope you have a great evening. You as well, Andreas. Until later. And here we have Carl, whom we have not met, I don't believe. Or have we? It's a person with a hat and a spoon in the hat. Evening, Andreas. Say, how do you like the bonfire? We built it nice this year. Big and sturdy. It's a fine setup, Carl. Excellent work. I know we can't compare to where you come from, but we still give it our all in celebration of the light who prepared the way for our Lord. Anton, you remember Andreas Mahler, the master artist? Ah, I've seen him around town. Son, be polite. Oh, hello, Master Mahler. How are you? I am well. Thank you, young man. Anton's a good boy, let me tell you. A bit of a rascal, as you can see, but he's got a good head and a good heart. Likes to hide it, though. Dad, will you stop? Easy to rile up, just like your mother. How's Elena? Is she not attending the bonfire? She'll join us later. She went with Martha to dip their toes into the stream and to pick some flowers for the garlands and wreaths. It's important to hold traditions. You're right, especially with the times we're having. Besides, maybe Martha and Elena will come across the blossom of a fern out there. That's what's so funny about that? Ferns don't flower. That means no power to speak with animals for you, boy. Wait. So the blossom of a fern, I think it is... Blossom is what results when a fern flowers, as the verb to flower. So coming across the blossom of a fern is to speak with animals? Is that what he means by that? That's weird. I'm not sure. I doubt they'd have anything interesting to say anyway, says Andreas. Animals can talk. I'm not a baby, you know. Indeed you are not, even as you're a bit short for your age. Dad. I joke. Now let's enjoy the celebrations. Speaking of, what do you think of the festival so far, Anton? Oh, it's fine, I guess. I like the fires when they're lit. The mountains get to twinkle like the stars. I don't like when people get drunk and rowdy as the night goes on. They get into fights and all. Oh, anyone in particular? Well, not as much lately, but Martin used to get in trouble. Anton's got a good eye. Martin's been a solid fellow once he came back, but he sometimes drinks too much. He's calmed down lately. You know, he used to be kind of a shit. Language, boy. God doesn't look kindly on blaspheming. But those are your words, Dad. Best you don't quote me. Quote the scripture instead. It's better for your soul. Don't listen to the old man, Anton. Have fun. Enjoy life. Curse all you want. I'm gonna wink at him. Now, Andreas, don't try to get the boy into any trouble. You think I'm strict? You should see what his mother will do if he catches Anton. She catches Anton cursing. Well, I'll let you get back to the festivities now. It was a pleasure. Until later, Andreas. Bye. The kids are having fun. The kitty is here as well. I hear the kitty. I don't know where the kitty is. It's over there. Right there. She was in front of it. And I couldn't see it. They brought the cat over. The cat would freak out with a bonfire. Like this. Potentially. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe the cat is just used to... to fires in their house and all that. So, I want to go to the forest. Because... Because of course I do. It's possible that we're going to have a talk with the women... who go to the river. Smokey should be around as well. Evening, Master Mahler. You're not taking part in the festivities? I came to ask you the same. I didn't see you at the bonfire.
I imagine it'd be a great chance to gather gossip. Plenty of gossip to go around if one keeps their eyes open in the forest tonight. It's an enchanting evening. I think he's a peeping Tom. As for your question, I get enough fire and smoke as it is. And decent folk don't like to associate with my kind. Even as they like the charcoal, they hate the burner. Other than Andris, he occasionally comes by, but I guess he has to keep good relations for his trade.
People avoid you even on a night such as this?
Well, fine. They're not as bad as usual. But, truth be told, I don't really care. I've made my peace with the matter. For me, it's a night like most others. I prefer staying sober and observing the townsfolk. Easier to get all the gossip for the year to come, you know? Besides, I reckon I'm growing too old for mischief. Best let others run around in their silly costumes.
I think you still have some youth in you.
Like the sun rises to its highest point every year, so my back grows ever more crooked. Ah, but I appreciate you coming by. Wish you a pleasant evening, Master Maller. Until later. Until then.
Curious.
It's good to have a chat with him. Tonight, there's fireflies. You see the fireflies? You have the Shrine of St. Satya. Let's go here. But nobody is around. And we have the waterfall. But nobody's around. Maybe it's not here. Yeah. Well, I guess I'm going to bed then. And here we are. Time to go to bed. Let me just make sure that is indeed my objective. I should turn in for the evening. It is. And tomorrow, Kaspar is dead, or something like that. Something terrible. Because he didn't have a mask. Or maybe he got somebody's mask. Look! It's the thing! Oh, it's this thing again. Oh, this is the puzzle. Or not puzzle, the labyrinth thing. Of the Lady of the Labyrinth. Shabin? What is it? She's not saying anything. Come home. I know. You know what? You want me home. You've been asking me for months. And for months, you haven't answered. What am I to you now? An annoyance? A bother? A nuisance to be ignored while you lead another life in Barcelona? Was there ever an ounce of love in your heart for me? As much as you had for me? You can't help but be cruel, can you? I'm gonna say nothing. Fine. Go back to your little schemes, the only thing that makes you happy. This house is so lonely without him. Stop. Your presence would only amplify the grief. Stop. I think him might be a baby. Leave me alone. Leave me alone with the memory of him. Stop! Just leave me alone, just for one night. One night where I don't have to dream about him. Please. Thank you. Oh. And now... Interesting. We spent a whole day... Oh, it's him, isn't it? We spent a whole day being like, oh, life has been difficult, there's the patrons and all that, and I'm sorry I didn't write.
And he contextualized his 7 years in a very different way. But he's a grown boy. He's not a baby. Hello, August. I know you are not going to say anything. You never say anything. I'm so tired, August. Do you get tired where you are? The last time I saw you, I said goodnight to you. I couldn't come to the bed, so I stood in the doorway. I just stood in the dark. It didn't say anything back, so I said it again. I don't know how long I stood there. Just waiting for you to say goodnight. You still look the same age to me. I wonder if I'll ever forget your face. Do you remember your mother as she is? I remember loving her. Can you ever picture someone clearly if you love them? I loved you, little boy. I wish I didn't. I'd rather erase 5 years of my memory than feel this anymore. Or paint it over with something. Anything. But I can't. So I retrace my steps every night. And I find my way back to her. Back to you. I love you, August. Good night. And the detail there for painting it over with anything is the name of the game. They just said the name of the game. They did. What happened to this place? Where's Prester John? And where are Socrates and St. Grovian? Grovian wasn't on the Ship of Fools. Melancholia is here. Hello? You want to answer me? No thoughts for Beatrice. You're Beatrice, aren't you? Once. I was a voice of caution. Of prudence. And now? More and less than caution. The ache of doubt that stiffens to paralysis. Paralysis that breeds despair. Melancholia. What happened to you? What happens to you happens to us. The foundations of this city are still moored within the ocean of your mind. Its court does not rule your mind. Your mind rules the court. Once reason, curiosity, and the foolishness of youth dwelt under the aegis of your intellect. And that's each one of them as well. I am all that remains. The melancholy of life's autumn. But it's only June. Wit can't save you from your own mind, Andreas. What can? A course other than the one you have already run. Another course. I'm 33. I have a wife, a workshop, clients across the empire. And it's brought you here, Andreas Maller. What am I supposed to do about it now? Change your life. Wait. I shouldn't be here. I needed to help someone. Is Gaspar all right? Oh, so your thoughts aren't entirely turned inward. There's still something in you that cares for others in spite of your melancholy. Perhaps there is still hope for us. Wake up, Andreas. Yep. St. John's Eve. Called it. Find Gaspar.